Stanford University.
Today we're here at Thunder Hill. It's a great place to test a lot of things that you wouldn't be able to do on a normal public road. We're really exploring autonomous vehicle control right up to the limits of what these cars are capable of doing.
We're using X1, which is a completely student-built vehicle test bed platform, and we're running it autonomously around an oval track on the skid pad. At the edge of one of the tight turns, the vehicle is operating at the edge of its vehicle handling limits, and then an obstacle will pop up and the vehicle has to adjust its trajectory.
What we built was our own sort of airbag by using plastic tablecloth and sewing it into a tube. And we use a leaf blower to inflate the tube across the entire lane, making the car be forced to make a lane change.
What we're really trying to test here is a control algorithm that can balance a lot of very challenging things that crop up when a car has to approach its physical capabilities. This controller is trying to not hit the obstacle, but it's also trying not to spin out. Of lesser priority, it's trying to do this smoothly so that an occupant isn't jerked around. And so there's a lot of conflicting objectives that have to be met. The car is making all these decisions itself. It goes into a turn and it's trying to use all the available grip. If it starts sliding, it can recognize that it's sliding and try and recover from that. And the hope is that if we can figure these things out in a controlled research environment like this, we can extend those ideas to production vehicles that may have autonomous capabilities in the future. If a car is physically capable of avoiding something, we'd like to develop the controllers that can make that happen.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.